stuff. So first, they all copy. You get pasta, spinach, steaks. It's the original, and it's still the best. I come there 2-3 times a month.
You get a man-sized cut of whatever type of meat that you want. I'm not trying to be sexist, but it's a great steakhouse for men. It's a great place for guys going for ball games.
This is true Chicago. If you want to really see Chicago, you have to come to Gene and George's.
Founded in 1941 by Chief Nicolotti and Alfredo Giorgetti Federighi, the steakhouse has been a Chicago institution for over 6 decades, and is still a family-owned affair.
I just hate to, I don't know if they'll take it back or not.
Well, of course they will.
They better, but...
Yeah, they will take it back. Or fix it.
Fix it, yeah. I'm not getting it fixed either.
And that's trying to screw that up for you.
Yeah.
Okay. Go get the bag. Put my shrimp. In.
You better keep them fresh.
Family on steakhouse.
Tony wasn't born into the family, but grew up down the block from the restaurant and stayed brought in here for the first time when he was just.
Thank you for looking at these, granddad.
As a little boy, I sit down with the family of the restaurant. There was lots of people to make tips. That's the little boy, that's me in the corner. The guy throwing it out is my father-in-law, Gene Nicolotti, the founder of the restaurant, who had always sent me a good boss. Okay? So I got lost, but came back the next night and continued all the drugs with people.
The mural was put up in 1997 as a tribute to Gene, a man whose presence still holds strong at their restaurant today.
He's an incredible man who worked every day with his high white apron, a cigarette in one hand, a martini in another, barking orders out to the people he worked for, and he loved him. So he created this oasis of happiness.
You can tell by our windows that they're old school. It's
wonderful. Yeah. Regular customers all have their own special orders. They call up and they arrange their reservation to have sports show, or want to list their before and so on, and they want to sit at this one different table. And you have a little chat well.
It doesn't change very much here.
The great state's familiar atmosphere at Gene and Giorgetti's has made them a favorite locals, tourists, and even for celebrities passing through the city.
My all-time hero was Joe DiMaggio, and he used to come here occasionally. Lucille Ball would be here with her entourage. Frank Sinatra's plane stopped here at Midway Airport to pick up steaks to bring back to his home in Palm Springs.
Celebrity sightings in Gene and Giorgetti is almost an everyday occurrence.
While Russell Crowe had a two-bone steak, which is a 32-ounce steak in tennis court, which surprised everybody at the table.
The biggest stars at Gene and Giorgetti's are, of course, the juicy, succulent steaks that fly out of the kitchen at a rate of about 200 a day. And the secret is all in the
preparation.
The steak world is divided into two major categories, those who dry age and those who wet age. Chicago is a wet-aging town.
We use wet-aged beef instead of dry-aged. The difference is dry-aged is hung by itself, and it's crusty on both ends because it's just dry-aged. It looks dried out when it's ready to be cut. Wet-aging, it's in its own juices, and there's no waste to it.
The vacuum-sealed wet-aged meat is left to age in the refrigerators for 3 weeks. Then it's ready to cut. Head chef Mario Navarro loves this new process.
The wet age, look at how beautiful it is, how fresh, how red, how marbled. So that's the difference. Thanks God, they make this kind of beef now. The marbling of the meat is the quality. You don't need to put nothing on. Just plain broiled is the quality of the meat.
The famous flavor of Gene and Giorgetti's steaks doesn't only come from the aging process, but also from the char. And a good charbroil requires some of the world's hottest ovens. We're talking 1,300 degrees of hot.
Normally, boilers are from the best are 700 to 800 degrees, and ours are modified accordingly. That's what makes the char of the steak. Char on the outside, juicy on the inside.
Master Broiler Mario has watched over these ovens for decades and still has an unstoppable passion for cooking.
My steak is gonna go to the table beautiful. Very tasty. So this is the best. Just I wanna teach you the secret to you before. Never pinch in the center, always in the tail. Because if you pinch in the center, it's like you make a flat tire. all the rules, you're gonna disappear from this thing.
Perfect steaks need perfect sides. And Mario also has a secret for making delectable cottage fries and onion rings. Eat that.
You'll see how the beautiful comes. Golden crispy. That's the way it comes. I'm very patient.